Are you okay, Jamanda?
Yes, miss. I find you are asking me the question.
Because you're not looking okay.
Miss, for the last time, I okay, right?
Alright, lose the attitude. Now, as the liver cirrhosis progresses, jaundice. Anybody knows about jaundice?
That's when your eyes turn yellow.
Very good, your eyes turn yellow. Jaundice, bleeding easily, clotting, swollen abdomen, confusion, sleepiness, and eventually coma. The person goes into a coma and then they die.
Mr. Peters, I could use the washroom, please.
Sure.
Thank you.
Oh my god!
What happened to her?
Yo!
Oh my god!
John, are you okay?
No, miss, I'm not okay.
Oh my god, somebody checked your pulse!
Oh lord, what happened?
Oh my god, and I think she like had a miscarriage.
Oh my god, look, what are you talking?
A liver biopsy test is a procedure which is done using a small needle that is inserted in the liver to collect a tissue sample. This biopsy test is often done to help identify the cause of persistent abnormal liver blood test, unexplained yellowing of skin, and unexplained enlargement of the liver and the abdomen. So we're placing the sample into a tube which will be carried to the pathology lab for further testing.
The liver is an organ located in the upper right side of the abdomen, and it is part of the digestive system. It performs several life-sustaining functions. It processes nutrients, produces proteins, stores sugar or glycogen, and it also controls the body's hormone levels, blood sugar levels, cholesterol levels, and fluid retention. The liver filters unwanted substances and helps the body fight infection. Cirrhosis is a chronic progressive liver disease that prevents the liver from functioning normally. This disease is most often caused by chronic alcoholism, but can also be caused by hepatitis infection and other illnesses. Damage to the liver from alcoholism or illness causes scar tissue to develop in the healthy liver tissue. Scar tissue prevents blood from flowing through the liver, preventing it from functioning properly. If the underlying cause of cirrhosis continues, for example, if a person with alcoholism continues to drink alcohol, cirrhosis will progress and liver function will diminish. Even if the cause of cirrhosis is corrected, the damage to the liver cannot be repaired or reversed.
Hi, so we got back the results from your friend's liver biopsy, right? And basically what it's showing is she has something called cirrhosis of the liver, right? Which is basically caused because of her heavy alcohol consumption. And what happens here is that, as said before, there's formation of fibrosis and nodular regeneration, which is the scar tissue forming in the liver, right? So basically, to break it further, break it down, cirrhosis comes in three stages, right? It will start off with a stage known as fatty liver disease, which is basically where the triglycerides, which is a fatty substance in the body, increases and is in excess. Now at this stage, it's reversible if you stop alcohol consumption. That is if alcohol is the cause of the cirrhosis, right? After fatty liver disease, you have a second stage which is called the alcoholic hepatitis, induced by alcohol, of course, in this patient. And basically this is where the there's inflammation now starting to occur in the liver. And at this stage, it may be reversible if you stop drinking the alcohol, right? Now, if you continue drinking the alcohol, of course, it will proceed into the last stage, which is cirrhosis, which basically means, as said before, the scar tissue formation. And here's where it is definitely irreversible, right? So the symptoms of someone having alcohol-induced cirrhosis could be very vague, right? It could be loss of appetite, tiredness, weakness. The more common things that you may see if it's in a later stage would be jaundice, which is basically the yellowing of your skin or white areas in your body. For example, like the sclera, the white area of your eye. It could also be, you could also get things like fever, constitutional symptoms, which are like common symptoms like tiredness and fever and whatnot. You could get something called itchy skin, which is like pruritus in the medical terms. That is a result of the buildup of the bilirubin under the skin, which is called also causes the jaundice. You could also get fluid retention. Now, fluid retention means that your body is self-explanatory. Your body is storing more fluid, right? This happens because as the liver degenerates, the capillaries, the blood supply to the liver is also affected by the alcohol consumption, and this causes the capillaries to become leaky, so to speak. And when it starts to become leaky and it produces fluid, it goes into the abdomen and the empty space in the abdomen, causing something called ascites, right? Now basically all this means is accumulation of the fluid in the free spaces of the abdomen, right? You can also get something called pruritus, which is basically due to the buildup of bilirubin in the blood levels, it causes an itchy skin, right? So, is it treatable and is it reversible or non-reversible? Now, I already explained when it becomes reversible and non-reversible. So, at later stages, which is the cirrhosis stage, it becomes irreversible. However, yes, it is treatable. Now, with the treatment, you also need to stop the underlying cause of the cirrhosis. So once the person stops drinking alcohol, as in your patient's, your friend's case, the cirrhosis or the degeneration of the liver would stop. However, if you are treating it, it doesn't mean that you get back all of your liver function, because the scar tissue remains as is, meaning that it is irreversible. So you will just remain with a liver functioning at a lower level as normal.
Will the same amount of alcohol affect everyone the same way?
Well, basically, the rate of alcohol metabolism depends on the amount of metabolic enzymes in the person's liver. And this will vary from individual to individual. It is something based on a genetic predisposition, right? And basically, alcohol is metabolized in the liver and it's metabolized more slowly than it is absorbed. So basically, when one is consuming alcohol, they need to be aware of how much they are consuming and at what rate they are consuming it at, because it takes longer for the body to metabolize than to absorb the alcohol, right? And if the body takes longer to metabolize the alcohol, it means When you keep on drinking or consuming the alcohol, it keeps building up in your body, the alcohol levels, that is, right? Now, basically, a number of factors influence the absorption process. And these include the amount of food you eat, the food type that you eat. The reason why this affects the alcohol absorption is because basically, when you eat a certain type of food, it may tend to close down and it delays the gastric emptying, right? So that's one of the factors that affect the alcohol consumption and absorption with the metabolism. The more fat content that you have in your system, the longer it takes to absorb within the system. And this causes the alcohol levels to reach faster at a higher level in that individual. This is why women tend to suffer with alcohol liver disease more than men, because they have a genetic disposition where they have a higher fat content as compared to.
So what causes an individual to become unconscious after alcohol consumption?
So basically what happens is that when you consume so much alcohol, right, the alcohol inhibits something called gluconeogenesis, which is a process whereby glucose is made in the body, right? How it inhibits this? It causes, as mentioned before, an excess of NADH production, and the NADH excess production causes an inhibition of the process of gluconeogenesis. So therefore, no more glucose is being made in your body, and this causes, obviously, for your glucose level to drop, since your body always needs glucose to carry out its processes within the cell functioning. So therefore, the glucose level drops, you get something called hypoglycemia, which leads to the patient becoming unconscious.
Alcohol, otherwise known as ethanol, is a toxic drug that produces cirrhosis in the liver tissue. Ethanol must be metabolized by the liver. This metabolism occurs in two pathways. The first pathway comprises of two steps. The first step is catalyzed by the enzyme alcohol dehydrogenase, which takes place in the cytoplasm, where ethanol is converted to acetaldehyde. In the second step, which takes place in the mitochondria, aldehyde dehydrogenase converts acetaldehyde to acetate. When ethanol is consumed, NADH is accumulated. This high concentration of NADH inhibits gluconeogenesis by preventing the oxidation of lactate to pyruvate, where lactate will accumulate, which may cause hypoglycemia and lactic acidosis. The high concentration of NADH also inhibits fatty acid oxidation, where NADH is generated for ATP by oxidative phosphorylation. When this occurs, triglycerides accumulate in the liver, leading to a condition known as fatty liver. The second pathway of ethanol metabolism generates acetaldehyde and acetate while oxidizing NADPH to NADP plus or minus. Because this pathway uses oxygen, free radicals are generated that cause the tissue to damage. In the liver, acetate is converted to acetyl-CoA, requiring ATP, by the enzyme triiodokinase. However, further processes of acetyl-CoA by the citric acid cycle is blocked because NADH inhibits it. The accumulation of acetyl-CoA forms ketone bodies that is released into the blood. Acetate in the liver therefore becomes inefficient, and this leads to a buildup of acetaldehyde. The acetaldehyde can significantly damage the liver if ethanol is consistently consumed at high levels. After testing the patient's blood pressure, ECG, liver biopsy, and with the informative information with Dr. Rampersad, we have concluded that the patient is suffering from hepatitis C. The patient's stomach was swollen because of the buildup of toxins and fluid. Her blood pressure was high due to overall fluid retention. Her skin was itchy because bile salts were building up on it. The patient was treated with antiviral medication, ribavirin, and interferon. These medications help slow down the attack on the liver. Therefore, the case of Jamanda, the alcoholic, was solved.